Australia's political capital is used to insults about the types it attracts, but there's one new arrival in Canberra who aptly fits the description of fat-bellied and slimy. It's the cane toad. Brought into Queensland in 1935 to combat the sugarcane beetle, cane toads have now spread far and wide, even invading Kakadu National Park in the Northern Territory. They have no known natural predators, and viruses from their native Venezuela are lethal to some of our native frogs. So CSIRO researchers have brought them to Canberra to try and stop their spread with gene technology.
Environmentally they're bad, but they do grow on you.
The toads are well looked after in a home heated to 27 degrees and they receive a weekly bath.
Oh, I generally leave them in there for about an hour and a half. That gives them plenty of time to shed the old skin and clean up the new area. I certainly appreciate it.
Then after the bath comes the romance. The toads are injected with hormones to get them in the mood, then left overnight to mate.
And we just put one male and one female in each tank and you come in the next morning and there's thousands of eggs just wrapped in nice concentric circles around the rock. And then we transfer them in the smaller tanks and the next day the tadpoles start hatching.
So far the team has just been assisting nature, but now the real science begins. This tadpole is being injected with an adult toad protein called beta globin, in the hope that its antibodies will reject it. If that happens, then its antibodies should also reject the tadpole's natural beta globin when it occurs, stopping it from turning into an adult.
We're injecting them with a possible protein that could be used in halting the metamorph of the tadpole into the toadlet.
Once the method is perfected, the gene that stops the maturing of the toad will be isolated and introduced into the toad population before they get to Canberra by themselves.